back to my YouTube channel. Back in the UK, I'm back at home. Excuse any mess, it's just been like a whirlwind ever since we got back. Basically, I've got to self-isolate until I get a negative test, and my test hasn't arrived yet. So basically, I had to send Tom out to go and get all the shopping, and it was a bit of a labor of love because we were literally like, you know, he was like showing me things on the phone and it was all a bit chaotic, but we managed to get some good bits, sent him off with quite a long list, bless him. Some Christmas bits, got some meal planning, and I've got all the prices as well. Really into this kind of content, please make sure you like, comment and subscribe. And let us just get on with the Christmas food. Okay, so we've actually been on the lookout for a wreath, and when Tom went in, he managed to find one, and it was £7. There were like other ones as well, but he showed me this was like the smallest one, and it was like the most reasonably priced ones. I swear, wreaths are just absolutely mental at the minute, and honestly, you just get like way too over the top with wreaths. So yeah, I'm pretty happy that he found this one, and it was £7, and it's got like little mushrooms on it and all of that nice little detailing. So yeah, and like a cute little bow, so can't really go wrong with that. Something else as well that's quite Christmassy, so this was, according to the list, this was £10. Now, what I've got in this one, I'm not entirely sure, but it is quite cool because it does come on for like a slate. It's like the Tesco Finest cheese selection on a slate board. So I suppose like if you had people over and stuff, that would be actually quite fancy, and you do get a slate with it, and this was £10. So yeah, it is quite expensive, but we do absolutely love our cheese. Okay, so he also, I kind of made him go back and get this. We were trying to find some Christmas jumpers. Well, he was trying to find a Christmas jumper for Robin. And anyway, found this one, and this was £11. And I was like, no, we need to get this one, Oh, it's all coming off. Basically, it's like a little, it's like a long sleeve top, and then it had this little like pinafore over it with this little reindeer, and I thought that was so cute. And yeah, 12 to 18 months. Okay, so also, we're trying to be on the lookout for stocking stuffers at the minute, and he did come across these, which were like a little bit, well, this was £4, and then this one over here, how much was Bing? Cute. I sort of sent him on a little mission to see if he could find any stocking stuffers, and luckily he did come back with something. Okay, so these look really, really, really good. The Mr. Kipling six chocolate orange tarts. These were just over £1. But these are the berry and beetroot bakes, which are, yeah, I think they actually look quite nice. Lossie has just eaten one, so she obviously quite likes it. And it's like a different kind of packaging to what they normally are. It's kind of like a papery material. I guess it's recyclable, so that's also quite nice. Yeah, it does say card and recycle with bag. So our bread situation, so like as normal, basically just get the same sort of bread. So with this, got the dark rye and sunflower farmhouse, and then we got a similar one down there. Okay, so I thought I would scooch on over here just for 1 minute, just to go to a meal plan before I forget. So £2.60, and I'm gonna be making the slow cooked, it's like a bacon and sausage slow cooker meal, and I will flag it up here, just over here, and you can obviously find the recipe linked to the description box down below. Basically, I did this like slow cooker recipe video, and that was one of the ones I cooked, and it is honestly, it was absolutely amazing. And with it, you'll also need some roasted red peppers. Okay, so this is actually quite expensive. It was just £3.50, and yeah, he actually got me some of this. Look at how amazing this looks. Vegan and high in fiber. Yeah, I'm actually quite surprised he got me this, to be honest, because he normally just gets me the standard stuff, and I've never seen this before either, so that's pretty good going. So yeah, the Pret classic granola, sweet and fruity with a cinnamon twist, so cannot wait to try some of that. I absolutely love my granola like first thing in the morning, so that's just as well. And then as always, like if you know, you know, but I get some organics bars, apple and orange soft oaty bars. I always have that written down. I always go pick that up. And then the strawberry and apple soft oaty bars as well. So this was a fiver. Loads of people get really confused by the instant coffee, but yeah, I really, really enjoy it. But I think I'm going to be investing in like a Keurig at some point, because when I went to America, my friend Laurel had a Keurig and I absolutely loved it. It was a revelation. And it tastes really, really similar to this anyway, so I just figured why not. But this is £5, so it is slightly more expensive than like regular instant coffee, if you know what I mean. So these, I just looked on the receipt, £2.80. I did ask if you could go and get me some like herbal tea bags. I'm not really sleeping very well at the minute with like jet lag and all of that, and having a pucker especially, they're just so, so, so nice. And I haven't tried basically any of these, actually. So I'm quite excited to give this one a go. And then what we are gonna have this week, there's no specific recipe, it's just like a pasta bake. So it has like halloumi and mozzarella and cheese and all of that on it. And Robin absolutely loves it. It's like mixed with pesto and things and always like roasted veg. And honestly, it's like a massive hit. The kids absolutely love it. So you do need halloumi and you need mozzarella as well. Also wrote down yogurt about a million times. So I got Greek style yogurt and then I then got Greek style yogurt, but then in a bigger tub. We honestly get through so much yogurt every single week. So this is just under a pound. I think it's like 85p. And then this is like £1 something. Got the Purina one, which is a little bit more expensive actually. I think it's like £4 something. Without reciting my list, I'm pretty sure it's around that realm. Yeah, it's Purina one. 1 to 12 months. Next thing I do get, and these are £2.50 each, so these are spinach and ricotta tortelloni, and the kids love this. It's just like such an easy thing to make, especially if they've got gymnastics and stuff. So I've got cheese and tomato, and then I've also got the spinach and ricotta. £1.89, which is actually like an amazing deal. And what I'm going to be making is I'm going to be making just like salmon with some rice and all of that kind of stuff. It's just something I really like making, or like a salmon sort of, is it niquoise salad with like potatoes, something like that. I just really fancied some salmon this week. The next thing on my meal plan, I'll flag it up here if you're not quite sure how to make it. It's just a cottage pie. It's just dead simple, but it's just something that I can throw together quite easily because we have so many potatoes left over. And yeah, we always get like the 5% fat, and we get like the smaller, slightly smaller version, not absolutely massive, because the massive one just makes like way too much of like the cottage pie mixture. Do you know what I mean? Okay, so breadsticks, multigrain crackers, yeah, we eat a lot of them as well, and they're just like so handy to have around. And then, oh, see down here as well, my little one's not very well, so it's sort of hidden, my little one's not very well, and I've got some cowpole. Yeah, so we've got some sugar-free infant, and then we also got some olives to go with the pasta bake. Massive thing of olives right there. This is like, I think it's just under £2, it's like £1.80 or something like that, but you get like a massive great big one. Nearly always get the big ones just because they go so quickly. And then some Branston, which was £1. I guess it was on special deal or something, but yeah, because the kids love that, having like cheese and pickle sandwiches. Got some more mustard as well. I literally just always get the Tesco, just standard Tesco brand. Okay, so over here, so we always get quite a few bits of cucumbers because honestly you get through it so quickly. We're going to need some dry cured bacon for the pork sausage dish. And yeah, what Tom did also get was this like continental selection made in Italy and Spain, which is basically prosciutto, mild salami and spicy chorizo, which is amazing because obviously now I've got the cheese, now I've got a bit of ham as well, so that's gonna be amazing. And the crackers, so I feel like it's all aligning. That's like one of Tom's and mine's like favorite thing to eat, is very picky food like that. Robin absolutely loves chicken. She loves chicken sandwiches, not really ham sandwiches, but she does really like chicken. This is actually quite expensive really, considering you only get six. £1.75 just for six, which I think is a little bit silly, but there we go. Right, I've got some Heinz beans as well because we'll be having jacket potatoes this week. And recently, just like jacket potato, cheese and beans is like the easiest thing to make ever, and we had completely run out of baked beans. So this one we normally get like I normally get the sugar-free version, but we've got these ones this week, the Heinz beans. One of the kids' favorite things is being asked, what kind of pasta do you want? And they don't know the names of it. They just know one's twizzly and the other one's like not twizzly. And they're like the shell ones as well. So got two different varieties, didn't stick to just one, got pen and fusilli as well. And then over here, it's basically just like all the veg we're gonna need for the different meals. So we've got some cherry tomatoes, got lots of fruit because I eat a lot of fruit. We've got some apples, got some strawberries. There are some raspberries just here. Got some leeks as well, got some organic leeks. Got quite a few avocados because I haven't had any in quite a long time, it feels like. And yeah, we've got quite a few. Got ones that need sort of ripening up, and then other ones which are ready to eat right now. Got some loose red peppers, and then got some ones in a packet. Got some British carrots as well. And yeah, just got loads of different types of tins. I've still got some tins left over in a bag, but I've got some finely chopped tomatoes. tomatoes, and then I've also got some beans, some kidney beans as well. So yeah, it's basically everything that we got in the supermarket today. Thank you so much for watching this haul. I'm so sorry if it was just like all over the show, but it's just the way that everything is currently today at the minute. But it went down absolutely fine. It was great. Managed to get all the bits that we needed. We managed to get there without me actually having to go in. So that was super, super good. If you really like this kind of content, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will catch up with you guys in the next video. Bye.